Hi, today I'm going to show you how to make a printed candle like this one. You can add some colour right the way around a pillow candle to whatever design that you like. It's really easy to do and they make really cute gifts. So first, you're going to need a plain candle. You'll also need some tracing paper and you'll need some heatproof paper or wax paper and some colour. So I've tried this using Sharpies. I've also tried using ink pads and stamps and also using a printer. So you can tape the tracing paper down to a piece of card, tape it all around the edge, and then you can run it through your printer. Okay, so first I'm going to take this piece of paper and I'm going to tape it right round all of the edges. You want to be really careful when you're doing this because you don't want the paper to come apart inside your printer. So you want the tape right along each of the edges, and I'll just do that for you now. Make sure it's all lined up perfectly. He gives, I get without giving anything to me. Okay, you just want to trim off any of the excess so nothing gets stuck inside your printer. So you want to measure your candle because you want to know what size image you want to print. So you can measure the top and then measure right the way around. If you don't have a bendy ruler, you can just wrap some tape around, rip it so it fits perfectly around the candle, and then just measure that piece. Okay, so using your computer, you want to make an image that fits those dimensions, and I'm just going to print off a Christmas image that I've made now. Okay, so as you can see here, I've printed a Merry Christmas with some candy canes. I drew a box first of all, and then made sure the image fitted inside that box. So you want to cut that out, and you want to cut as close to the printed image as you can. So you want to follow it round as closely as possible, so there's very little tracing paper left. I got really excited when I first figured this out, and I think I've told absolutely everybody I know that they need to make these with their kids for Christmas presents. So sorry to everyone that I've been hassling with this. I just had so much fun making them myself. There we go. So I've cut out the Merry Christmas and the candy canes. So you want to bin the piece of paper and just keep the tracing paper. This is where the fun part starts. So you take your candle, remove any packaging that's still on the candle. I just got these for about £1, maybe £2 from Home Bargain. Any kind of candle will do. You can do it on coloured candles as well. So you want to place the tracing paper image over the top of the candle, and you want to line it up exactly where you want it to be. You want to make sure it's nice and smooth. Maybe if there's a couple of edges that you still need to cut, just neaten those up. Then you want to take a sheet of wax paper. You can also use greaseproof paper. You'll need to apply some heat to the candle. So I'm going to use a heat tool. So you want to make sure that there's some extra space at the back so you can make a handle so you don't burn your hand. And if you don't have a heat tool, you can use a hairdryer as well. Okay, so make sure you keep your hand out of the way and start applying some heat. So the candle and the wax paper will very gently melt, and as they do that, you'll see that the tracing paper seems to sink into the candle, and it goes from kind of a quite a white colour sat on top of the candle. It, as it sinks in, it absorbs the colour of the candle, so you'll notice a difference. I'll just try and show that to you now. So you will find that you get some kind of melted wax on the top of your paper. So I recommend that you don't do this on top of carpet. It will end up as a mess. So as you peel that paper off, I should be able to show you the difference in colour now between the places that have stuck to the candle and the places that are still loose. So it's still quite white here. And then around this edge, you can see it's kind of sunk into the candle more. It's quite white here. And there, it's quite seamless with the candle. So you just want to keep taking your wax paper or your greaseproof paper, wrapping it back around the candle, making sure your hand's out the way, and applying some more heat, and keep doing that all the way around until all of the tracing paper has been absorbed by the candle. Okay, there you have it. That's your finished candle. All of that tracing paper has been absorbed, and you're left with the printed image on the candle. So now, I want to wrap my candle up, and there's a couple of different ways that you can package them. So I'll just get this out of the way, and then I'll show you. Okay, so I've got these cellophane bags that have got kind of little Christmas trees printed on them. So you can pop the candle inside one of these. Scrunch it up at the top, maybe add a tag, maybe add some sequins inside the bag. But what I'm going to be doing with this one today is using some shrink wrap. So it's clear plastic that actually shrinks as you apply heat. So you just want to cut a piece and wrap it around your candle. And then again, I'm going to take the heat tool and just apply some heat around the bottom and the top. So you can't really see on the video, but the plastic is shrinking and fitting itself around the candle perfectly. There you go. And that's it. It's ready to send out as a gift. Hope you've enjoyed watching. Thank you.